All right, let's make sure we have everything for Moses, because he's going to come and we're going to ask a question. What did Moses say? Well, we're going to look at Numbers 13 and see exactly what Moses said, because he's the one who went up on the mountain and talked to Hashem. We should listen. We're going to start with a beautiful song that's going to make the entire night awesome. Jesus in Disguise.
Never get something in your head.
Here's an offering to Hashem. It's chocolate. It is. Smells like chocolate, but there's no smoke. So it's going to make me feel good, but there's no aroma from this. So this is man-made chocolate. But it's good. Thank you, Hashem. Sesame, open hemp seed, open sesame seed, open my heart to you, Hashem. Thank you. I really appreciate you teaching me and doing everything you've done for me. Thank you. Yep, speak the word my lips have never known. So with that, we got some work to do. What are we doing? What did Moses say? We're going to jump right into Numbers 13, and we're going to learn something tonight. It's going to be fascinating. We're going to go exploring. We're going to go exploring like spies. You guys ready? Oh my goodness, it's going to be so exciting. All right, so we're going to go to Numbers, and actually I'm going to go to my Torah. Torah time, Torah time, Torah time. Look, Torah and cannabis and Rastafarianism. All blended into one? Yes, because God's most high and he's done all of it himself. So, do we thank it very often? Nope. People say, oh, don't talk about religion. No, don't do that. In fact, I was totally telling a girl at an ice cream store tonight. She was, really? I have an entire system? Yeah, and God most high and he loves incense and she totally understands that. She was totally laughing, and for about 7 or 8 minutes while we were in the store, she was like, wowed. It's a fascinating topic to think that God Most High, who gave us an entire system of cannabis, which happens to make us feel good, could actually be on for good. But woe to those who say it's evil, right? So, Numbers 13, as we flip and flop. So we're going to read it. And we're going to get started. We're going to do an offering real quick. Because it's a good story. I'm not going to talk much and describe it. The story describes itself. So I'm just going to read. Thank you, Hashem. Let's go exploring to the land of Canaan. We're going to go exploring to the land of Canaan. Okay. Numbers 13, the command to send spies to Eretz Israel, which is Israel. Hashem spoke to Moses, saying, send forth men, if you please, and let them spy out the land of Canaan, the land of Cana, 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 it's missing an H, Canaan, Canaan, that I give to the children of Israel. Send forth men and let them spy out the land of Canaan that I give to the children of Israel. Again, God's giving us land, it's the land of Canaan, that's why I think it's Cana. Of course, it's not Calamus or Calamity. God's going to give us the land of Calamity. No thanks. I'll pass. Oh, you mean that's Earth? Thanks. Can I get off this Calamity or off this callous rock into some smooth, melting, burning aroma? Yes. One man each from his father's tribe shall you send, every one a leader among them. Moses sent them forth from the wilderness of Paran at Hashem's command. They were all distinguished men, heads of the children of Israel, were they? These are their names. For the tribe of Reuben, Shammua, son of Zakur. For the tribe of Simeon, Shaphat, son of Horai. For the tribe of Judah, Caleb, son of Jephaniah. For the tribe of Issachar, Yigal, son of Joseph. For the tribe of Ephraim, Hoshea, son of Nun. For the tribe of Benjamin, yay, Paul! Palti, son of Raphu. For the tribe of Zebulun, Gadiel, son of Sodi. For the tribe of Joseph, Joseph! For the tribe of Joseph, for the tribe of Manasseh, Manasseh, Gadi, son of Susi. For the tribe of Dan, Amiel, son of Gemali. For the tribe of Asher, Sether, son of Michael. For the tribe of Naphtali, Nabi, son of Vashvi. For the tribe of Gad, Guiel, son of Maki. These are the names of the men whom Moses sent to spy out the land. Moses called Hoshea, son of Nun, Joshua. Hoshea is Joshua. Hoshea, Joshua, very similar. So Moses prays for Joshua. Moses sent them to spy out the land of Canaan. And he said to them, ascend there in the south and climb the mountain. See the land. How is it? And the people that dwells in it. Is it strong or weak? Is it few or numerous? And how is the land in which it dwells? Is it good or bad? And he's talking about heaven, or he's talking about earth, but he's talking about cannabis, and Cana is the root word for Canaan. So he's talking about a land of Cana, a land of Cana and Kaneh, a land of branches, aromatic resin. What happens when you burn the branch hemp? You get aromatic resin in your body, and it sticks to your cannabinoid receivers, CB1 and CB2, they start talking to each other, and you start getting creative thoughts. Let's start ascribing those to God, okay? Our thoughts, God. Listen, ask a question, ask him how he's doing. So, is the land of Cana good or bad? And how are the cities? Is it fertile? I'm sorry, how are the cities in which it dwells? Are they open or are they fortified? How are our hearts? How is our body? How is our mind? Are they open-minded? Open fist, open palm, or closed fist, closed heart? Karate, always look eye, always look to the Hashem. Sorry. And how is the land? How is the land of Cana? Cana? Cain? Is it fertile or is it lean? Is it fertile or is it lean? And that goes back to Genesis 41:5 with the seven heads of grain all growing on a single stalk, healthy and full, and then the skinny, weak ones ate it up. Are there trees in it or not? So the land of Canaan, Cana, he's asking, is it fertile and are there trees? Go spy it out. We've spied it out. We think we have a good report. Some people say it's a bad report. Oh my goodness. You shall strengthen yourselves and take from the fruit of the land. You shall strengthen yourselves and take from the fruit of the land. Take this cup It is my flesh. It is my blood. Eat it and remember me. Drink it and remember me. Get high and remember me. I'm the branch. The days, not the nights, but the days were the season of the first ripe grapes. Grapes, the first ripe grapes, which have no value, right? Interesting. Grape tree, no value. But people get confused with alcohol and fermentation. So, let's finish. They ascended and spied out the land. See, this is like a murder mystery. They're going to spy out the land. Listen, gather around, guys. They ascended and spied out the land from the wilderness of Zin to the expanse above, possibly, at the approach of Hamath. They ascended in the south, and he arrived at Hebron, where there were Ahiman, Shishai, and Talmai, the offspring of the giant, the offspring of the giants. Okay, Ahiman. Well, Ahi is tuna, so maybe that's a tunaman. And Shishai. She is shy. I don't know, this is what I do to words. The offspring of the giant. So there's a giant, and the giant had offspring. So the Nephilim, Genesis 6, is the giants. Enoch describes them as 3,000 ells tall. 3,000 ells tall. How long is an ell? 18 inches. 4,500 feet tall are the giants. Yeah, we look like ants to them, or grasshoppers. And we felt like grasshoppers in our own eyes, right? So Hebron had been built 7 years before Zone of Egypt. They arrived at the valley of Eshel and cut from there a vine. They arrived at Eshcol, Eshcol, it's Eshcol, hash and coal, Eshcol, Hashcol. E is hay, so it's hash coal. And cut from there a vine with one cluster of grapes, and bore it on a double pole, and of the pomegranates, and of the figs. The pomegranates, I love it. There's your pomegranate. Pomegranate, right? P-O-M-E. P-O-M-E, is it an apple? Is it a pomegranate? Or is it your palm? Is it hemp? And also, and the figs, right? The figs. They named the place the Valley of Eshcol because of the cluster that the children of Israel cut from there. There it is, right? You guys can see that. That's the vine that they brought back. This grape thing, right? Do we have a bigger one? No. So let's continue and round it out. So they returned from spying on the land of Cana at the end of 40 days. Jesus wandered for 40 days. The Israelites were under oppression for 400 years. They spied the land for 40 days. I've had 40 years, 47, before I knew any of this. From 7 to 47 is 40 years. Now I'm awakening. I'm waking up. I have cannabis. I have the word. God talks. Voila, that's what's coming. Warning, that's what's coming. In the palm of your hand? Right. So they returned from spying, and they went and came to Moses and to Aaron and to the entire assembly of the children of Israel to the wilderness of Paran at Kadesh and brought back the report to them and the entire assembly. Here's the report on the land of Cana. And they showed them the fruit of the land. The fruit of the land of Cana. the fruit of the land. They reported to him and said, we arrived at the land to which you sent us. Earth, Cana, cannabis, and indeed it flows with milk and honey. Now, they did not see milk and honey flowing on the ground. That would be sticky. Wait, sticky as in resin, sticky. As in resin, as in air flowing with milk and honey. The air, smoky, everyone's burning incense, right? We were there for 40 days, guys. It is a land flowing with milk and honey. Milk honey, milk Kaneh, my Kaneh. Take out the word and you get milk Kaneh. Milk Kaneh, my Kaneh, my Kaneh. My story is a mystery. His story is history, right? I love the words, right? So, it flows with milk and honey, and this is its fruit. Okay, its fruit, milk and honey, pomegranates, and fig trees. Palm, fig of a tree, honey and milk, burning, incense, aroma, we're narrowing it down. It's definitely not calamus, but we're really getting knee deep in this, maybe waist high. But the people that dwell in the land is powerful. The cities are fortified and very great. And we also saw the offspring of the giant. Amalek dwells there in the area of the south. The Hittite, the Jebusite, and the Amorite dwell on the mountain, earth. It's talking about earth. All of the evil ones were cast out of heaven when they decided to come down and have, you know, relations with any woman they wanted to. They wanted to tap that from heaven to earth, Genesis 6. Hey guys, see that woman down there? Let's go tap it. We're still tapping it today. And then we tap a keg. Let's stop tapping both that and let's tap into our minds and tap into our body with cannabis. So they saw all the giants in all this land. And the Canaanite dwells by the sea on the bank of the Jordan. The Canaanite dwells by the sea. Which one? The waters above, the waters below. The Canaanite dwells by the sea on the bank of the Jordan, which is where I bank. Caleb silenced the people toward Moses and said, we shall surely ascend, rise up, higher, elevate ourselves, and conquer it, for we can surely do it. But the men who had ascended with him said, we cannot ascend. To that people, for it is too strong for us. They brought forth to the children of Israel an evil report on the land of Cana that they had spied out. So Caleb says we can do it. The other guys say we can't. It's about the land, and they're arguing a good report or a bad report about the land of Canaanites, the land of Cana, Cana, Kaneh, the holy anointing oil. God's not going to send you into a land and only give you one seed to choose from. It's his Garden of Eden. And guess what, guys? He's the guardian of Eden. Guard Eden. Guard Eden. Guardian. That's another play on words. We are supposed to guard Eden, for she, Eden, is beautiful, glorious. And if you add fire to Eden, she lights up and she becomes a beautiful golden ball. Aromatic incense, right? Fragrant, aromatic resin, gold. That's the sun. No one has ever thought, let's go live on the sun. That's all I talk about. We can burn continually as an aroma pleasing or like smoke in your nostrils. Well, I want to be smoking the nostrils on the pleasing side. So I switched lines, I read the book, I offer my offerings from the palm of my hand, not the apple, which has no value. One seed, one woven clothing, linen belt stories coming up soon. But there you have it. So they have the land. Cana, there's a good report or there's a bad report. 2018, there's a bad report about cannabis. I'm trying to spread a good report now. And that is the good news. So let's go see what Jesus did in spreading the good news about the kingdom.